Hello, math students. This is Ms. Jacobs. I'm going to talk about one more question, question 62, critical thinking. Write a series of if-then statements that allow you to find the measure of each angle, given that the measure of angle 1 is 90 degrees. Use the definition of linear pairs. So take a look at this this diagram. So use the definition of linear pairs. What that means is that the sum of the two angles must equal 180 degrees. The sum of the two angles that are linear pairs must be 180 degrees. So using that definition of linear pairs, let's write a couple of if-then statements defining all of the measure angles, angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, and angle 4. So what do we know? We know that the measure of angle 1 is 90 degrees. Oh, you broke it, silly girl.
Oh, Mommy's broken.
Oh, you can't pull it.
It's okay.
So the measure of angle 1 is 90 degrees, so let's find the measure of angle 2. Well, angle 1 and angle 2 are linear pairs, right? So, if they are linear pairs, this is what we know. If the measure of angle 1 is 90 degrees, then the measure of angle 2 must also be 90 degrees. And that should make sense because linear pairs sum to 180. And what's 90 plus 90? 180. So we know this is going to be 90 degrees as well. Maybe I'll even write it in my diagram, little box. Now look at angle 2 and angle 3. Those are linear pairs, right? Angle 2 and 3 are linear pairs. So you can write, if the measure of angle 2 equals 90 degrees, yay, then the measure of angle 3 is 90 degrees. Again, think about it. Linear pairs sum to 180. Two and three are linear pair angles, therefore the sum must be 180. And finally, angles 3 and 4 are linear pairs. So, and there you have it, same rationale. Angles 3 and 4 are linear pairs, so the sum must be 180. And if you know 3 is 90, angle 3 is 90 degrees, then 4 must be 90 degrees as well. So I hope that helps. Like I always say, study hard, learn a lot, and we will see you soon. Bye-bye.